Hey, I'm Simon and I'm here at AirBeamTV to show you how to mirror your Mac to your Panasonic Smart TV. Today, I'm using my trusty 2013 MacBook Pro, which is updated to the latest OS, Big Sur, and this should work on any Panasonic Smart TV from 2012 onwards. So let's get started. So the first thing that I need to do is download the app for my Mac. So I need to head to the AirBeamTV website at airbeam.tv. They really nailed it with that. Then click this button that says download the app. It'll scroll me down to a list of TVs. And there's mine, Panasonic. Click on that and then click app for Mac. Download the trial now, which will allow me to test the app out unhindered to make sure I'm super happy with how it works. I'll then save that to my desktop, which should only take a second because it's a very small app, and then I can go ahead and install the app like I would any other app. So I'll just open the DMG file and then I will drag the app into my applications folder, like so. So now that the app is installed, I'll close down all those windows and we can head into our applications folder and open the app for the first time. One thing to make sure is that your laptop and your TV are both connected to the same network. We have a wired connection in the back of here and this is connected via Wi-Fi. So let's open the app for the first time. And as soon as I do, it says Mirror for Panasonic TV is an app downloaded from the internet. True story. Are you sure you want to open it? Yeah, go on. Let's do it. Yes. So click open and then it will pop up at the top in our menu bar. And I will go ahead and click the menu bar like it says to get started. So the app will pop up this little box that says allow screen recording. Now we are not recording your actual screen. We're not saving any of your data. It's just that's the function that allows the image to be projected to your TV. So we have to click allow on that in order to mirror the image. So I'm gonna open system preferences like it says here. And then you need to click the lock. Don't look at my password. And then give Mirror for Panasonic TV permission. And then we will have to quit and reopen that once it's allowed it. So we've allowed the screen recording and the app has restarted. So we just head back up and click to open it again. And this time we see the little menu with our TV listed as target device. Now, just before we get to our mirroring, we need to click enable sound on TV. And when we do that, it will ask us to install the audio driver. So if I click install, then we will get a little installer and that will talk us through the installation of this driver. Very simple, just follow the instructions. And the audio driver is installed. So now we click on the menu bar. We click enable sound on TV and it says allow access to microphone. Again, we will not be recording you or keeping any of this data. It's just necessary for the audio driver to send the sound over to our TV. So again, I will click authorize and okay. And we are so close. Now I'm gonna click scale display to fit the TV screen so that it fits exactly the same. And then I will click start mirroring. After the little whirly wheel does its magic, my laptop screen will be mirrored onto my Panasonic TV. And there it is. Maybe you wanna show people some delightful pictures. Oh, some pictures that I've taken over the years. There is a little delay, we call that latency. That's not gonna be a problem if you're looking at pictures or business presentations or streaming, but it does mean that you're not gonna be able to do gaming, unfortunately. So there's some pictures, what else can we do? Maybe we want to see something on a website or something that doesn't have an app on the TV itself. For example, Vimeo. So we can head over to Vimeo. And if I play a video here, pop that into full screen. And as you can hear, the sound coming out of the TV and not my laptop. Wonderful. Pro tip, if you are mirroring from your browser for a streaming service like Netflix or Disney Plus, we recommend using Chrome or Firefox for the best performance. Safari at the moment doesn't quite support the full functionality. And that's how easy it is. If you have any questions, feel free to get in touch with us via Facebook Messenger or email. In the meantime, happy mirroring.